Competitive cheerleading is a global phenomenon. With over 4 million cheerleaders worldwide, cheerleading has become a billion-dollar industry. In fact, competitive cheerleading may make an appearance in the 2020 Olympic Games in Tokyo. Sue Wood is the head coach of the most successful cheer program in Michigan history, and in her 4 decades at Rochester, she says the sport is continuously evolving.
Cheerleading is something that originated to fire up the fans and get them behind another sports team, and now competitive cheer is our own sports team.
Competitive cheerleading became an official sport sanctioned by the MHSAA in 1994, separating itself from sideline cheer, which you typically see at football and basketball games. Competitive cheerleading is centered around stunts, jumps, and tumbling, and requires extensive athletic abilities.
We really, truly mean it when we say we're a sport.
It's not all about like the skirts and the bows like everybody thinks it is. We work just as hard, if not harder, as any football player, wrestler, basketball player, anybody.
With a football player, if they're just right about to get that touchdown and they get it, it's just the same as when we're walking to that formation, the last formation of round 3, and the stunt goes up, we say our last words, and the crowd's screaming with us. That is definitely our touchdown, and we know that we have taken the gym by surprise.
My reaction when somebody says cheerleading isn't a sport, it used to be, okay, I want to like prove them wrong, oh my gosh, this, and I would get so mad at them. But now I almost feel like I don't need to prove myself by my words. Come to one of our competitions and you will see for yourself.
These girls don't mess around, and their athleticism is undeniable. It's easy to see why competitive cheerleading continues to be one of the most popular sports amongst girls in Michigan. For In Focus, I'm Kiera Hay.